So this is how the new Bing search looks like. Instead of the normal search bar, we have like now a bigger box where you can enter up to 1000 characters, and on the top also this is like a new carousel where you can see some new information, and there is on top a chat option. When you click on it, nothing spectacular, but you see the normal search results for it, and a window pop up saying that it's joined the waiting list for chat. So yesterday there was like a presentation from Microsoft. Now let's look at some of the important new features. So this is like the new interface of Bing search, and when you do a search, you can see the results from ChatGPT on the right side. As in ChatGPT, you also have the option to give a feedback whether it's good or bad on the top, like the thumbs up and thumbs down. And when you type in a search, as you can see, it will populate all the best results for that particular search. So this is right, taking real-time information. So if you type in like a event since Cordell during Super Bowl, so as you can see, it's really relevant. And when he did a search for like the best 65-inch TV, it populated a list of TVs. And if you click on that search chat button on top, and it will take that result and display it here in this interface. And what the best thing is, now you can actually drill down to your specific needs for it. For example, if we, and from those results, he is asking for which is the best for gaming. So it's going through the result and it's displaying what are the best TVs that's best for gaming. And now then he asked cheapest one, it's showing that as well. And this is how the user interface will look like, somewhat similar to our old ChatGPT interface. And he is asking again for like an itinerary for 5-day trip. So it's just giving the answers like in ChatGPT, and you can see the reference are also given at the bottom, and so where the information is taken from, so you will have a correct idea of where you are getting the info as well. So again, he's asking for like family vegetarian options meal plan, and as you can see, it's citing the links there from where the information is taken from. This is running on a later version, after 3.5, so it's the latest version of ChatGPT, and they also showcased how you can use it with the Edge browser. This is the most exciting feature for me. This will be soon rolled out to all the Edge browsers. And for example, he is taking some financial results page, and it's like a lot of information on this page, like the 15 pages information. So with this, when you click on it and just type in like key takeaways from this page, it will go through this entire page and give you like the exact key takeaways for this page. And you can also compare with the other pages related to this as well, so you don't have to switch around. You can just ask it and you will have the data there itself. Another use case he showed was like for the coding example, like you can just copy this code here and you can just interact with this like in ChatGPT. And he asked to convert this code to Rust, then it was able to do that as well. So as you can see, it's converting the code. So that's the another useful use case with it. And the main use case that I am really excited about is this compose one, where we can actually start writing articles, emails, blog posts, and ideas, and just clicking on it will just copy paste this into this post. So a time saving feature for everyone who is working in the social media space and for content writing. Are you excited for this new technology? Will you be using it in your day-to-day life? Will you prefer Google Chrome browser or Edge browser after you watched this video, and let me know in the comments below. And if you enjoyed the video, do like, share and subscribe, and thank you for watching. Have a great day.